morning to all. In the previous grammar class, we already learned about kinds of sentences. Students, I hope you all have revised that chapter. So students, today in this video, we are going to learn about subject and predicate. Subject and predicate, that is chapter number 3, subject and predicate. Subject and predicate. So students, in this chapter, we have to study about subject and predicate in a sentence. Subject and predicate in a sentence. Okay? Okay students, a complete sentence has two parts. A complete sentence has two parts. Okay? A complete sentence has two parts. Complete sentence has two parts. First one, subject, and second one, predicate. A complete sentence has two parts. First one subject and second one predicate. Okay? Subject is a naming part. Subject is a naming part. Subject is a naming part. Predicate is a telling part. Predicate is a telling part. Subject is a naming part and predicate is a telling part. Okay. Subject tells who or what the sentence is about. Subject tells who or what the sentence is about. Okay. Predicate tells what the subject is or does. Predicate tells what the subject is or does. Okay. So, subject tells who or what the sentence is about. Subject tells who or what the sentence is about. And predicate tells what the subject is or does. What the subject is or does. So students, a complete sentence has two parts. First one subject and second one predicate. Subject is a naming part and predicate is a telling part. Subject is a naming part and predicate is a telling part. And subject tells who or what the sentence is about. And predicate tells what the subject is doing. Okay? Clear? So, a complete sentence has two parts. First one subject and second one predicate. Okay? Clear? Okay students, let us move on to the first part of the sentence. Okay, first part of the sentence. Subject is the first part of the sentence. Subject is the first part of the sentence. Okay. Subject tells who or what the sentence is about. Subject tells who or what the sentence is about. That means subject gives the answers of two questions that are who or what. Okay, who or what. So subject tells who or what the sentence is about. Okay, subject tells who or what the sentence is about. Okay, subject will give the answers of two questions that are who or what. Okay, clear? So, subject tells who or what the sentence is about. Okay, next point. A subject is a part. Okay, that is being spoken about. A subject is a part that is being spoken about. Okay, so subject gives the information about a person, place, animal or a thing. Okay, person, place, animal or a thing. Clear? So a subject tells who or what the sentence is about, and a subject is a part that is being spoken about. That is being spoken about. Clear? Okay, students. Next point. In the most of the sentences, subject is placed in the beginning of the sentence. Okay. In the most of the sentences, the subject is placed in the beginning of the sentence. The beginning of the sentence. So, in the most of the sentences, subject is placed in the beginning. The beginning of the sentence. Okay. Subject is placed in the beginning of the sentence. Okay. So, students, subject is the first part of a sentence and subject tells who or what the sentence is about, and subject is a part that being spoken about. Okay. Then, in most of the sentences, says the subject is placed in the beginning of the sentence. The subject is placed in the beginning of the sentence. Okay? Okay, students. Look at these examples. Mary had a little lamb. First one, Mary had a little lamb. Okay? Okay, students, tell me. Here, we are talking about who? Yes. Here, we are talking about Mary. Here we are talking about Mary. So students, a subject tells who or what the sentence is about. Here we are talking about Mary. So Mary is the subject of this sentence. Okay, Mary is the subject of this sentence. Clear? Then, subject is placed in the beginning of the sentence. Okay, subject is placed in the beginning of the sentence. So, look at this example. Here, Mary is the beginning word. So, a subject is placed in the beginning of the sentence. So, Mary is the subject of this sentence. Clear? So, subject is who or what the sentence is about. Okay, in this sentence, we are talking about Mary. So, Mary is the subject of the sentence. And subject is placed in the beginning of the sentence. And Mary is the beginning word of this sentence. Clear? Next example. The baby is crying. The baby is crying. Okay, here we are talking about the baby. So, baby is the subject of this sentence. Okay. Next one. The cat is running. The cat is running. Here we are talking about cat. So, the cat is the beginning word of the sentence and this is the subject. Okay. Clear? So, students, subject is who or what the sentence is about. And in the most of the sentences, subject is placed in the beginning part of the sentence. Beginning of the sentence. Clear?